The NEO project, which was also incorporating the GigaPress, is a series of sub-projects that have been brought together to realize a revolutionary concept. Each one of the sub-projects had its own unique set of challenges and timelines that we strove very hard to maintain. Each department head was directly involved to ensure that their contribution was received on time and that the net result was within a controlled budget. It's important that when we design, we consider not only the technical content, but also the final cost to the customer. In the end, you can have the best machine in the world, but if it's not at the right cost, then you'll never sell it. Utilizing both the engineering and the marketing team, we had the best people available working on this project. In total, there were more than 100 people working on the project, and each one was responsible for a small portion. And in the end, a mechanical technical department under the leadership of engineer Dioni had to bring everything together in a single package, which we could present to the customer. Very much enthusiasm is required to continue and push through the blockages that arise during such a design revolution. The most important thing is to believe in what you're doing and to understand the effects that your work can have on an entire industry. For sure, there were moments of difficulty, especially given the fact that we were essentially designing a machine and a system that nobody had requested. We knew that the automotive industry was very keen to reduce weight in the vehicles. We also knew that the foundries wanted to play a part in the future of automotive production. But the big question was, what would we use such a large machine to do? When we presented the machine to the world at GIFA exhibition in June 2019, it was very much a sole effort. The rest of the industry was doing totally different things, and to be honest with you, there were many, many skeptics. We were in a certain way revolutionary, and as such were sometimes viewed as over-optimistic. However, I believe that the results have vindicated everything and everyone that worked so hard to realize it. The machine was designed as a modular concept, so we were able to work on each section individually. The concept was broken down into sub-projects based around items such as the injection or the guarding system, and each one of these sub-projects was assigned to a team leader. The team leader was normally the head of the department, who was responsible for ensuring that his team delivered on time a working concept, which was then followed by an alpha phase design. It was very important to benchmark the industry and ensure that at each step we continued to head in the right direction for achieving the ultimate goal. It's important to note that these activities had to run concurrently alongside a very busy production schedule, in which each department also had to deliver machines on time for the customer. The work of actually building the GigaPress was nearly 3 years after the birth of a concept and wasn't really a single point of manufacturing. For certain items, we had to create prototypes and work with the sub-suppliers to deliver test solutions which we could evaluate and understand if we arrived where we wanted to be. A really great example of this is the 5S injection system, which we needed to build a prototype and test the prototype in-house at IDRA. Then find a machine on which to install it. This is important to test the injection in a hot production environment with a die and aluminium affecting the performance of the system. For this phase, we were very fortunate to have a partner in the FSA that runs regular testing of injection characteristics. CoStamp, our die design and manufacture partners, agreed to allow us to install a test injection to one of their machines, which was great. This enabled us to test the injection on many different components, both structural and powertrain. Needless to say, it was very successful, and the prototype injection is still in production today, even 5 years later.